Looking forward to this, a director of a pre-born life center recalling the story of, like so many young women who were determined to abort her own child until...
One of the memories I have was with a client who came in by herself, and she, I believe she had an ultrasound. She expressed to us that she was probably going to have an abortion because her boyfriend was pressuring her, and she felt like that would be, you know, the thing to do to make everybody happy. But when she left, we still didn't know what her decision was, but she took with her a little baby bag that we gave every client, and we would stuff it with things that helped a client, you know, remember the positive experience that they had had in their visit. And when she got home, we found out later, she told us that her boyfriend was looking in it, and he took out the little fetal model that we would put in each bag of a 12-week-old unborn fetus with all the little hands and the feet and the fingers, and he put it in his hand like this, and she said he looked at it and he looked at it, and finally he said, I don't think we should abort this baby.
Don't recall the statistic, but it's something like 60-70% of abortions are forced by a husband, a boyfriend, or a father. This boyfriend saw his child right there, 12 weeks, and chose life. That is what is going on at preborn centers all day, every day, but they can only do that when they can provide free ultrasounds. They do cost money. $28 a piece. Could you provide a free ultrasound that almost certainly 80% of the time will save the life of a human being? If that sounds exciting to you, and I don't know how it can't, would you please visit preborn.org?